Okay, so this is a boxing of all unboxings. Purchased this on Kijiji, so this is a mail day video. Happened to just find it. Asked him if it was still available. Obviously it was. Asked him if he would mail it. Did. Paid for insurance. Paid for shipping. Came from Calgary, Alberta. Shipped to Nova Scotia. Basically, it was, it's kind of one of those bucket list locomotives purchases that you really want. There, I just kind of gave it away that it's a locomotive. So let's just get something out of here. Hopefully, I can do my that if I did. Pretty large box. Alright, so what's the space saver? Yeah, just so it doesn't move around so much. Vertically in box. Packaged very well. I don't know anything being given away with me unwrapping it, but yeah, definitely bubble wrap, that's a great shape. You could probably make it out now with the bubble wrap on it. I'm gonna pull this right out and then get rid of the box. So, as you can see, you could probably make it out. There it is. So, unfortunately, which is no big deal, but the previous owner who bought this new didn't get the protective sleeve from the hobby shop he bought it from, unfortunately. I did approach Otter Valley just in case they may have, but they didn't. But I also approached Rapido Trains just to see if they had the outer sleeve. The box obviously has got some shelf wear and dents and dings, but what this is let's see if I can adjust my lighting here so it's not giving me a glare. Royal Hudson. There we go. Canadian Pacific H1C coal tender number 2846 DCC and sound. So I got this for an unbelievable price. I'm not going to actually tell you what I paid for it, but it was a deal, a once in a lifetime situation. Couldn't pass it up. You know, secondhand, these are going for 500 and up. Brand new, they were, you know, $700, maybe less a discount. From your dealer, and then shipping, which basically they covered with the discount. So this is all the paperwork that came with it so far, and I'm not overly concerned. If there's any, okay, so parts bag, couple of different chimneys, looks like some brake line hoses, a dummy coupler, and some other bits. And this is the tool to change the drivers. If I remember correctly, of course, you've got the hex nut here, flat screwdriver there, and Phillips there. Plus it can go on a key ring. Ooh. And then we've got rubber traction tires and the drive wheels. If you don't like traction tires, you can replace the drive wheels. Which is all good. So, here's the tender. Still in focus? I hope I'm still in focus. I didn't ask the original owner what his reason for selling was. I was more interested in the purchase, not why he was selling. Well, here's the tender. Looks like all the details are there. Now, he's one of those guys that cut off the trip pin off the coupler. I'm not a fan of that, but that's fine. If I want to switch it out, I will. I don't know if it's just dusty or if there's just slight weathering. But that's okay, and there's the bellows. So we've got a 2-pin and an 8-pin. That's kind of odd. And here's the locomotive. It's in good shape. I'm not seeing any damaged pieces. 2846. Oh yeah, there's the other wire. Interesting. All right, I'm going to put it on my track. Now, I just have a regular Bachmann Easy Track 18-inch radius curve, but we can try it out on the straight track anyway. I'm going to pause and reposition. All right, so there it is on the track. Flip some power on, I guess. We got the room. Number board lights up. /28/46. Let's see if that's it. Headlight. Oh yes, so there is a delay. Bell? That's a pretty cool ring. Horn? Whistle? I don't like that one. I'll be changing that. Glass lids. it manages 18-inch curves. Not prototypically, but it does. That's pretty cool. I know of. Just it, when it jumped from module to module, it, I don't know what happened, but see, the wheels probably need a little cleaning. Okay. Thanks for coming.
Bag. Only bag I have big enough to put the box in.
Thank you.